Hi guys, it's Nicole and Albert here again from Relax My Dog. We're here every week answering all of your doggy related questions. This week we're going to be covering the facts that you need to know before fostering a dog from your local shelter. There are thousands of dogs that need that little transition period of fostering before they find their forever home. And if you've ever considered it, then you need to know these basic six facts before you do. Now, there's no perfect profile of a foster family, but there are some things that you need to know before you become one. Now, there are many different types of fostering, and you might be having to care for a dog with behavioural issues, a new puppy, or a dog that needs medical attention as well. Now, all of these things are going to require you getting some advice from your local shelter, which they will always give to you. But there are also some different things that you need to think about. It may be the case that you are looking after a dog who is getting over an illness. Now, if this is the case, there may be different types of medication that you need to give them, or you may have to bathe them periodically if they've had any kind of skin condition. With this, it's also really important to remember if you've got any pets already in your house, you may have to keep them separate from your foster dog, as they might have contagious illnesses. Now, it's always a really good idea to get in touch with your vet if you have any concerns about these or how to keep your pets away from your foster dog. If you're looking after a dog who has temperament or behavioural issues, then you may be required to give him basic training, like house training him if he's a puppy, or even an older dog, sometimes they need house training too. And also giving him socialisation so he stops things like chewing or jumping on strangers. Now, this is really good if you've already got pets or children, because this is going to be really good for his socialisation. But it is something that you need to consider about whether you've got the time to give to your foster dog and to teach him these basic training skills. Now, foster programs are really important for most shelters because of overcrowding issues. Now, these overcrowding issues unfortunately do mean that most older dogs or dogs with illnesses do end up having to be euthanized because they just simply haven't got the room for them. And that's why fostering is so important. For many foster families, the biggest concern is whether you're gonna just fall in love with the dog and need to take him on. And as we all know, as soon as you meet a dog, you do fall in love with them and you wanna take them home with you. But unfortunately, this isn't always the best idea. Purely because if you take on the dog, if you adopt the dog, then you are simply one less foster family for the other dogs that are in that shelter. And shelters do rely on foster families, so if you give up that chance and you adopt the dog that you've been fostering, that's just one less family that they can rely on. Now, one of the biggest concerns for foster families is the time commitment that it takes to foster a dog. Now, by no means do you have to spend 24 hours a day with the dog, but you do have to make sure that you've got enough time to look after him. If there's training required, you need to make sure that you've got enough time for this. And as we all know, dogs are hard work. So if you've got another one in the family and you've already got some, it might be a time constraint that you just can't commit to. There's also no time limit on fostering dogs. You may be asked to look after a dog for 2 weeks. It might be 2 months, it might be 3 months. So it's just whether you can put your life on hold for this foster dog. Obviously you're not gonna be able to go away for the weekend or go on family holidays while you've got your foster dog. So it's just whether you can commit that time to the foster dog for however long it needs before it finds its forever home. Now, for many people, the financial commitments are also a worry about fostering dogs. Usually the shelter will pay for any vet's visits or medications and even things like bedding and crates and dog bowls if you request for them. However, there is always the dog food, which isn't usually provided by the shelter. So if you can't afford this, then it's really something that you need to consider before thinking about fostering a dog. Now, I think we've just about covered everything. Hopefully this video was really helpful for you if you are considering fostering. If you do have any other questions, then please do leave them in the comments section below. And similarly, if you have fostered dogs before, we'd love to hear your advice. We'd love to hear any advice that you've got for our other subscribers and anyone thinking about fostering dogs. So please do leave them in the comments section below as well. If you did enjoy the video, please do give us a big thumbs up. Thank you. But that's it from us for now, so we'll see you again next week. Bye! Say bye, Albie. Bye! 'Cole and Albert here from Relax My Dog. We're here every week answering all of your doggy related questions. Now, this week we've had a lot of you asking about different problems that you're having when trying to groom your dog. So I'm going to go through our top 6 tips for how to groom your dog successfully and how to relieve any anxiety that they may have about the grooming process. Now, we've had a lot of you saying that your dogs get really scared when you do try and groom them. Now, this is a really common thing with dogs. And